It's rowdy here in Fist Energy Stadium. Even though the economy is a mess in this city, these are some of the best sports fans in the country.
I heard things were so bad that Leland Casino was turned into an Indian reservation, Grim. Yeah, why don't you just open a window and take a leak all over the fans?
Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this NFL matchup. The Los Angeles Volts go up against the Cleveland Burns. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. And NFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And it's 1st and 10. Oh, man, what a throw. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. 1st down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's 1st and 10. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown. Touchdown. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Boom! They'll be scraping his pieces off the field for months after that hit.
Yeah, you have to admire him, Grin. He really leaves his heart on the field. And his liver, and his lungs, oh, and his skull.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's 1st and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and long. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb.
He scores!
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks.
I know, I hate those zebra men.
Oh, Second and three. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Oh, crowd's loving it. And it's first and ten. Gets the ball, get the first down, and don't die. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten. Today, folks, these teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. First and eight to go. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And that'll bring up second and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Well, guys, I'm supposed to be impartial, but this ref is so dirty. He should be buried most of all. Buried in the dirt. Second down and one. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't going to happen, partner. Offense is rolling.
Mongren, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
Third down and nine. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. The 10! And he recovers the fumble and runs it back for a defensive score! That's a backbreaker for the offense! Turner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. Hey, Bricks, they're going for two here. And he gets into the end zone for the conversion. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And it's first and ten. They've called a zap attack. The ball kick. Oh, welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles.
My cellmate prison did a dance like this my first night in a big house. It was trouble then, and it's trouble now.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
How do you like your defense, Cook? The ball carrier and the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Grim!
Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And it's first and ten. Cannonball. First down.
Yeah, my next door neighbor was a human cannonball, Grim. He drowned in his pool.
And it's first and ten. Got that pass play, and that's some 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick your head in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. That ought to stop them.
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? And it's first and ten. You don't hear it coming. He can go all the way. He's at the 40. The 30. He's running out of gas now. He's at. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First down and nine. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
First down and nine. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Missed a beat for Brain Fan, but the ball didn't fall down.
We should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. And an interception. Hey, Bricks, you were hit more than a few times like that in your career.
140 times to be exact, and one game to be more exact, during one play to be more exact. It wasn't even a game, actually. Coach just laid into me on the sidelines.
And it's first and ten. The coach said the offense was going to be explosive this week. He meant it literally. Second down and ten. And like a monkey trying to...
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have.
Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! That's why we love the NFL! Third and four. Gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league. And the runner is moving crazy bad. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
And it's first and ten. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And that'll bring up second and one.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and ten. First and ten. And that's a run for no gain. Second down and ten. And the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. Oh, with a brutal hit. Second down and a lot. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down and long. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about bad hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and 10. The defense calls a sticky ball. And they just popped his eyes in the back of his head. That quarterback could be hurting or dead. Second down and more than the QB would like. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. The warning sounds. Only 2 minutes left in the first half. Third down and 9. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't.
Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this outcome.
And it's first and 10. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
The offense is running low on blockers. They have only 2 left. If they lose another, it's game over. And it's first and 10. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and 5. Crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
And it's first and 10. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost...
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron. It's first and ten. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Not many kickers can kick it over 50 yards in these brutal conditions. Let's see if he can do what few others can.
That was like a movie trailer, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Seminole will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they can start cheating and killing. That's what I do.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten.
You can't keep... Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
And it's first and ten. The quarterback just perfect pass for the score!
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
You know, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good! The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. He refuses to go down. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback calls a sonic blast dirty trick and throws a supersonic. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Listen to his fans howl. They love him. He came up as a teenage werewolf in the Mutant Farm League.
I don't know if he's dancing or just marking his territory.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff.
Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10.
Freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB, if there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and 9. QB says, I don't always throw interceptions, but when I do...
You have a bottle of hot sauce shoved up your ass?
Quite the description of that painful hit, Junior.
Huh? No, it's a question here on this online dating profile. It doesn't say if on purpose or by accident. Yeah, I'll leave a blank.
And it's first and 10. And that's another turnover for the defense.
Before you know it, we're letting in cat girls. You know, things really start to get weird at that point.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five!
You can't keep a good mutant down.
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. It's first and 10. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
Complete pass. Looks like the defense got away with that one there.
I didn't want to grab the receiver like that. He could get hurt.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. And the NFL winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. The offense is running low on receivers. They have only 2 left. They might consider running the ball more. And it's 1st and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on? Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. first and 10. And that play went nowhere fast. No gain. Second down and 10. Some of his entrails are in the stands.
That'll make a great souvenir for the kids.
The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. Second down and a lot. Scrambler. And it's first and 10. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays. Talk about luck!
And it's first and 10.
Ah, another interception. They should give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined.
Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And they're catching up.
Joke, jump, do something.
You know, his great-grandfather was in that movie Alien 17.
Where is Ripley when you need her to bust out the big guns? He's just leaving one big skid mark out there. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. And it's first and 10. Oh, he just got popped big time.
Oh, my God. I thought his head was going to pop off like a big zit.
And it's first and 10. And it's another pick. Man, oh, man, the defense is going to have more receptions than the offense. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Oh. there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sit.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls call me
I don't know if he even had a target on that throw. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me.
Oh, that was a close one.
First down. And this guy, oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The Cleveland Burns got their asses kicked and handed to them today and lose by forfeit. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's game was brought to you by Comcrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.